Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to share with you how you can put together this beautiful bagel slash toast station that is perfect for any brunch. The very first thing I'm doing is taking out my butter and putting it in its butter dish so that it can come down to room temperature, because there's nothing worse than hard butter when you're ready to use it. And then we're going to go ahead and start assembling our spreads. These spreads, you can make them the night before. That way in the morning you just have to assemble everything and toast the bread. If you guys are new to my channel, I hope you subscribe. I upload videos every week, and also give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it. The first one is this avocado spread that has sort of like an Asian fusion style to it. It's gonna have avocados, pineapple, mango, red chili flakes, lots of lime juice, and my secret ingredient, sesame oil. Feel free to skip the sesame oil if it's not your thing. It's still going to be just as delicious, and I will have the exact measurements to everything listed down below for you guys. This is very simple to throw together. You can use frozen or fresh fruit. And at the very end, you do wanna top it off with a little bit of sea salt. Just kind of taste it as you go. And we're gonna go ahead and refrigerate that and work on our second spread. The second one is an egg salad spread, and this is basically a deconstructed deviled egg. It's absolutely delicious, and again, it's also something you can prepare ahead of time. And I love this because even if you overcook your eggs, this salad is so forgiving that it's not the end of the world. So you're gonna go ahead and boil your eggs. Once they're nice and hard boiled, go ahead and peel them, cut them in half, put the yolk in a mixing bowl, and then put the egg whites aside. We're gonna add those at the very end. To the egg yolks, we're gonna be adding red onion, dill pickles, garlic powder, paprika, celery salt, parsley. You wanna give that a good mix until it's nice and creamy. It's okay if some of the yolk is still a little bit chunky. That's totally fine. And then we're gonna chop up the egg whites into tiny little cubes and mix that into the egg yolk mixture. Go ahead and refrigerate that, and we're gonna start assembling everything right now. For breads, we're gonna be using mini bagels, but I also wanted to use two other types of bread, one being a whole grain bread. This is gonna go really well with the avocado spread that we created because it's a little bit on the sweeter side. And then we're also gonna be including sourdough because this is a really safe option. I think a lot of people like sourdough, and we're gonna go ahead and toast it in the oven. You can do this about 20 minutes before you're ready to serve everything. Put it on 350 degrees and let it toast for 10 minutes on each side. Or you could also have a toaster kind of set up in your little station, that would work as well too. While the bread is toasting, we can go ahead and assemble our little bagel station. We're gonna be using lox for this. You can find this near the seafood area, and this is already cooked, you guys. It already comes pre-sliced, so it's super easy, and then we're gonna be adding some sliced cucumbers. And if you guys want your cucumber to look a little bit more special, all you have to do is get a little peeler and kind of peel sections of it like you guys see that I'm doing. And when you're ready to slice it, you'll see how it forms this like crinkly edge. It's really pretty. We're also adding some fresh tomato slices, some red onions, and just make sure your onions are super thinly sliced so it's easy to assemble your toast. And then I'm also gonna be adding capers. I absolutely love capers. I'm also including some everything but the bagel seasoning. This is the stuff that I get from Trader Joe's that I'm obsessed with. And then I also cut up my lemon wedges in really easy pieces to grab and squeeze. Then I added my cream cheese. I made sure it was nice and soft. I'm also using some fresh dill, and this is going to also add a nice garnish, but it's also gonna taste really good with the bagels. Now that all my essentials are on the plate, all that's left to do is kind of make it look pretty. So I try to make it look as full as possible. So I'm adding the mini bagels to the perimeter of the platter, and it looks absolutely gorgeous. Next, we're assembling the avocado spread. And for this, like I said, we're using the whole grain bread. I'm also adding some cucumber slices. And just to make it look a little bit fuller, I did add some parsley and some orange slices. And then I went ahead and filled the rest of the cutting board with some sesame seeds. This serves two purposes. It adds a little bit of extra garnish, and it also lets people know that there is sesame oil in the food. At the very end, I drizzled the top of the avocado with a little bit of sesame oil. Last is the egg salad spread, and for this I'm using the sourdough bread. I left some untoasted and also added some that I toasted. I served that with a side of pesto, also some baby tomatoes, some red chili flakes, which I served on the little cap, and a little bit of Parmesan cheese. A few things that I think would make a nice addition to the table are another bread basket, butter, also some sea salt, definitely need some honey to go with that butter. And I also found this at Trader Joe's the other day. It's basically a little seasoning that's filled with different nuts and spices. Dip your bread in the olive oil and then you dip that into the seasoning, and it's really tasty. I've actually never had this before. Comment down below if you guys have and if I'm eating it properly. But yeah, I thought it would be a really fun addition to the table. Of course, you can have so much fun with this and be as creative as you want. You could try including a little section of sweets, like if you like Nutella or maybe some hummus. It's totally up to you. The possibilities really are endless. I've done several of these brunch videos on my channel before, so I will link them down below. Subscribe if you're new and also give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I will talk to you guys next time. Always alone.